Hi, I am Avlin and I'm an intern with Lexus and Company, and today I'm going to discuss the topic of attempt. Broadly speaking, there are four stages in the commission of an offence. First one is intention, second is preparation, third is attempt, and when the attempt is successful, it becomes a crime. So that is an offence. So initially, intention is not punishable, and therefore attempt is the first offence which is being made punishable under IPC. Mostly, offences like attempt to murder, attempt to commit suicide are being specifically mentioned in IPC, but some offences are there whose attempts have not been made punishable per se in IPC. So all those sections are there, although those punishments are dealt by section 511 of IPC. So what is attempt? Attempt cannot be specifically defined, and it has not even been defined by the act per se. So what constitutes an attempt? We can say that this is a mixed question of law and fact, depending largely on the circumstances and particularly from case to case. The word attempt means to try and to endeavor. Attempt means an act towards the commission of an offense which fails due to the circumstances independent of the attempter's will. Thus, it means any voluntary act which does not fructify into the intended results. In attempt, it is the motive which makes the act wrongful, even though the act in itself is not wrongful. A person commits an offense, attempts to commit an offense of a particular offense. When he intends to commit that particular offense, he made preparation and does any act towards the commission of that offence. It is not necessary that only the accused must have done the overt act in the commission of the offence, but it is enough that the act has been done in the commission of or completion of that particular offence. Thus, if one walks out of his house with a loaded gun to kill someone, here he has made preparation for the commission of the offence. But if no overt act has been performed, that is, if the person having a loaded gun has not shot someone, then he cannot be held liable for an attempt of that offence. Therefore, it is impossible to hold that person guilty. It is not necessary for an offence to fall under the ambit of 501, that the offence or the attempt must end as an offence if it is not interrupted. To be liable for an attempt under this section, it is not necessary that the circumstances should be such that it must have facilitated in the commission of the crime. So, if an act is done with an intention and preparation has been made, but the act itself is impossible to perform, then the person shall not be held liable for an attempt. If a man with an intent to kill someone makes preparation by administering poison and gives the same substance to the person, gives a harmless substance to the person believing that to be poison, cannot be held for an attempt of the offence. So that means that where the attempt or the act is impossible, nobody is going to die with the administration of that harmful substance. Therefore, the person cannot be held liable for an attempt. The thing here which has to be noted is that for an attempt, the failure must be due to the intervention of some factor independent of one's will. This statement means that let's just understand this statement with an example. For example, if A administers poison to B, so what here does what A does here is A pours a glass of water and adds poison in it. B, aware of the act, when A turns his back, B spills the water and spills the poisonous water and adds a fresh glass of water, which he further administers to C. So here in this case, A will be held liable for an attempt of causing hurt because of administration of poison, because here the act of A was intervened by the act of B of spilling away the poisonous water, and A had no intention to do so. So A's will was to kill B or to harm B with the administration of poison, but he could not do so. But still he shall be liable for an attempt under section 511 of IPC. The other thing which has to be kept in mind that is that an act towards the commission of an offence must be or need to be penalty made. That is, last act after which the crime results. But such an act must be proximate to the intended result. The measure of proximity here does not relate to time and action, but it relates to intention, which means that the crime must have been committed, the act must have been performed with an intent to the commission of the crime. There must not be any lapse. So while committing an offence, only then such an act must intervene the act that he cannot complete his act. Only then he shall be liable for attempt, not after a moment or after a lapse of his intention to harm the other person. So merely doing preparation for the commission of an act is not punishable in IPC. For example, A was followed by B in a fair because B wanted to pick his pocket. So after touching the pocket from outside, he feels that the pocket is empty. So here B cannot be held liable for attempt, but we can only say that he was making in preparation by making sure that whether there is something to be taken from the pocket of A or not. But in the same case, if B would have put his hand inside the pocket of A, here it would have held B has committed an attempt to theft. So this was all about attempt. I hope you enjoyed the session. So thank you so much.